Hello, this is my Twisty Puzzle chess set. All 32 pieces are fully functional puzzles and it took me several months to complete. Each piece is based on a 2x2, though I've added some features that makes them more interesting. There's 8 different pawn designs, for example, and the king has an additional assembly element to it. I would describe it as an obese version of the classic Staunton chess set, though the knight is 100% my design. I made the knights by sculpting the required shapes in plasticine, making silicon rubber moulds, and then casting the parts in polyurethane resin. The other pieces were designed with CAD, shaped by Zen 3D printed masters, which I could then make moulds of, before casting the pieces again in polyurethane resin. So let's go through the pieces then. Now, I would consider this pawn the most sort of straightforward piece, and the king is the most kind of interesting piece. So I could have easily made all the pieces like this. So this is just a very straightforward 2x2 modification. So you've just got the 8 different pieces and you just solve it like a basic 2x2. In fact, it's easier than a 2x2 because these can go anywhere and these can go anywhere on the top. So that, you know, I could have made all the pieces sort of similar to that, but I wanted to make them a little bit more interesting than that. So the best one I think is a king, because a king has like the normal 8 pieces for a 2x2, but also the cross is like a completely different kind of piece. So that actually comes out like that. That's like an assembly sort of puzzle, you could say. After that's taken out, it then moves like a regular 2x2, but you will notice that the pieces are different, and it's because of the way they're shaped that allows the cross to go in. Now if you swapped over a couple of those top pieces like that, you suddenly find that this piece won't go in. So what you'd have to do, you have to decide based on these kind of like indentations how the how it allows that piece to go in. And I mean, if you obviously, I know the puzzle because I designed it, but if you didn't know the puzzle, you also wouldn't necessarily know how it inserts and goes in, what movement is required. So I just think that makes it a little bit more kind of interesting. So I'm just going to scramble it and do a solve. You'll notice that I've put these kind of like soft pads on the bottom, which is obviously sort of fairly standard. I think often chess sets have green ones, but I didn't really want the green on a white chess piece. So let's do a solve. Obviously for me it's kind of easy because I know exactly what piece has to go where. Right, so if anybody else was solving this, at this stage, they would have to check to see whether those pieces are right. So it goes in, turns, go down, and turns again. So that's right. But in order to complete the puzzle, you obviously got to take that out because you've still got the bottom to solve. Although the bottom pieces obviously need to be correctly orientated, they can go sort of in any position. So it's still quite an easy puzzle. Right, so put the top in. And that's the king solved. Now, let's take a look at the queen. Now, the queen moves in all the normal ways, so it's certainly less interesting than the king. The thing about the queen though is these pieces still have to be in exactly the right position, because the little kind of like bits on the crown, there's 9 of them, and the way they're distributed means there's only one place that they can actually go, and it's quite a subtle difference. You have to look really sort of hard, so it's kind of a deliberate annoyance, let's say, for the solver. It's not immediately obvious where they go. Right. Obviously, as a designer, I know that piece goes opposite that on the top. Right, then after that, it's not quite so obvious. I'm gonna have to just try and see what looks right. Because the differences are very, very subtle. Right, I think that's right. I'll know when I put in the next one. Yeah, you can see how they're all distributed quite evenly. There's a few little air bubbles and other kind of inaccuracies and blemishes and stuff, but I'm fairly happy with these pieces. Just gonna do the bottom. And that's a queen done. All right, a bishop. Now the bishop has this kind of overhang. So although it still moves like a regular 2x2, this overhang's going to cause an issue because if you move it like that, it blocks. So again, I thought that would be an interesting kind of feature to include. And of course, you know, it's only a 2x2 with a couple of overhangs, so it's not going to cause any great issues. You might kind of get stuck with it first time, but you're quickly going to figure out how to do it. One thing that I definitely don't like about this set is the way that you can see the internal 2x2 there, and that's because it's like a stickerless one, so it's got lots of colors on. And I did try to color it white, but it just didn't work, so I have to put up with that. Right, so that's a bishop solved. I didn't run into any trouble there. I was just kind of lucky. So both bishops are the same, identical design, and they're also the same for the black side as well. So let's go on to the rook. And again, the rook moves in all directions, just like a 2x2. Now, the design of the rook is that you've got like these sort of turrets, and that piece is identical to that piece, and that piece is identical to that piece. So it's really a very easy 2x2 without any great problems. And both white rooks are the same, and also the black rooks are the same as well. What am I doing? Right, so that's a rook solved. Now the knight is one of my favorites. I said earlier that all these others I did with CAD, computer-aided design, using Google SketchUp. I then sent the files off to Shapeways, and they sent me back like the 3D printed parts, and I then made molds of the parts and then cast the resin pieces. So all of these are like made of resin, they're not 3D printed parts as such. Now this one I couldn't do in Google SketchUp, and I kind of wanted to do something, you know, 100% myself, if you know what I mean, not to rely on CAD or Shapeways or whatever. So this was all sculptured by myself, which is why it looks a bit naff. Now it's similar to the bishops in that the way it moves, there's kind of like this massive overhang. So when you mix it up, you can get these weird sort of like blocking things going on. And in fact, because it's a horse, you can get all kind of weird sort of animals. The movement, by the way, on these is pretty good. I struggle sometimes a little bit because the way the bits are all sticking out, you end up not lining up things properly, but the movement is basically okay. Right, again, you can see how it's gonna block. So let's go for a let's go for a solve. These pieces are very similar, but there is subtle differences, so they do have to go in the right position. Right, so that's the knight solved. Again, both the knights are identical designs, and they are on the black side as well. So the pawns, I've already showed you that one. I'm not going to solve every pawn, but I'm just going to go through the designs. Now, this pawn includes like an overhang in the same sort of way as the knight and the bishop did. So with the overhang, you're getting blocking, which kind of confuses things a little bit, but ultimately they're just 2x2s. This one, you've got two overhangs, so it's a little bit harder. It's going to cause more blocking. This one has got bandaging but no blocking, so those two pieces are bandaged, so you can't move it that way, but obviously everything else is okay. This one is, so you've got overhang. So this one's similar to that one, but that one's actually, I meant to say, it's got bandaging there as well. So it's not bandaged here. So that one actually had bandaging and overhang, whereas this one's just got overhang. This one has got bandaging and overhang as well. So those two pieces are bandaged, and you can see that's overhanging there. Now this one's the simplest of them all. This has just got two bandage pieces, so there's not much you can really do with that one. I mean, it still, it still takes a little bit of solving if you don't know puzzles, but to anybody watching, I'm sure would be really easy. And this one again has a combination of bandaging and overhang, so you've got those two pieces are bandaged, and you've got that overhang. And I think this is probably the most interesting of them all, because it's not difficult, but it's possibly the most difficult out of the pawns. So that's my Twisty Puzzle chess set. As far as I know, nobody else in the world has ever made one. There is at least one puzzle chess set you can get, which is kind of like made of metal, and it's not twisty, it's another sort of puzzle. I have construction videos for all of these pieces and also the board, so check out the link in my description for that. It might not be there yet, but it will be sometime in the future.